Good morning and welcome to morning prayer on this day when we remember Maximilian Kolb. I'm Reverend Anne. I am the vicar here in the parish of Luton, St. Anne with St. Christopher. You are most welcome. Whether this is the first time you have been here for morning prayer or whether you have been here day by day, you're welcome. And together we worship God. As I said, today is the day on which we remember Maximilian Kolb. Today is the day on which he died in 1941. He was born near Lodz in Poland in 1894. He became a priest, and as part of his priestly ministry, set about setting up a communion, a community of people that gained a huge following. And as the Nazis invaded Poland, Maximilian Kolb was arrested as an intellectual and was taken to Auschwitz in May 1941. It was there that he continued his priestly ministry, celebrating the Holy Eucharist in private. There was an escape from Auschwitz, and 10 people were to be executed. Maximilian Kolb volunteered to take the place of one of those men. Thus he gave his life freely and willingly for another. And so we begin our service. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us heartily rejoice in the rock of our salvation. Let us come into his presence with thanksgiving and be glad in him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hands are the depths of the earth, and the heights of the mountains are his also. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands have moulded the dry land. Come, let us worship and bow down, and kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he is our God. We are the people of his pasture, and the sheep of his hand. Oh, that today you would listen to his voice. Harden not your hearts as at Meribah, on that day at Massah in the wilderness, when your forebears tested me and put me to the proof, though they had seen my works. 40 years long I detested that generation and said, this people are wayward in their hearts. They do not know my ways. So I swore in my wrath, they shall not enter my rest. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. The night has passed, and the day lies open before us. Let us pray with one heart and mind. As we rejoice in the gift of this new day, so may the light of your presence, O God, set our hearts on fire with love for you, now and forever. Amen. And if you do have our daily prayer book, we turn now to our psalm, Psalm 51, which can be found on page 722. We'll say this antiphonally, so if you have the words, please do join with the even-numbered verses. And the refrain which will be said throughout at different points is, "The sacrifice of God is a broken spirit." The sacrifice of God is a broken spirit. Have mercy on me, O God, in your great goodness. According to the abundance of your compassion, blot out my offenses. Wash me thoroughly from my wickedness, and cleanse me from my sin. For I acknowledge my faults, and my sin is ever before me. Against you only have I sinned, and done what is evil in your sight, so that you are justified in your sentence and righteous in your judgment. The sacrifice of God is a broken spirit. I have been wicked even from my birth, a sinner when my mother conceived me. Behold, you desire truth deep within me, and shall make me understand wisdom in the depths of my heart. Purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Make me hear of joy and gladness, that the bones you have broken may rejoice. The sacrifice of God is a broken spirit. Turn your face from my sins, and blot out all my misdeeds. Make me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from me. Give me again the joy of your salvation, and sustain me with your gracious spirit. Then shall I teach your ways to the wicked, and sinners shall return to you. The sacrifice of God is a broken spirit. Deliver me from my guilt, O God, the God of my salvation, and my tongue shall sing of your righteousness. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth shall proclaim your praise. For you desire no sacrifice, else I would give it. You take no delight in burnt offerings. The sacrifice of God is a broken spirit. A broken and contrite heart, O God, you will not despise. The sacrifice of God is a broken spirit. O be favorable and gracious to Zion. Build up the walls of Jerusalem. Then you will accept sacrifices offered in righteousness, the burnt offerings and oblations. Then shall they offer up bulls on your altar. The sacrifice of God is a broken spirit. Pray, good Lord, the sin that corrupts us. Give us the sorrow that heals, and the joy that praises, and restore by grace your own image within us, that we may take our place among your people. In Jesus Christ our Lord. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. And so we come to our first reading from Scripture. Today, coming from the first book of Samuel, chapter 22, verses 6 to the end. Saul heard that David and those who were with him had been located. Saul was sitting at Gibeah under the tamarisk tree on the height with his spear in his hand and all his servants standing around him. Saul said to his servants who stood around him, "Hear now, you Benjamites, tell the son of Jesse, give every one of your fields and vineyards. Will he make you all commanders of thousands and commanders of hundreds? Is that why all of you have conspired against me? No one discloses to me when my son makes a league with the son of Jesse. None of you is sorry for me or discloses to me that my son has stirred up my servant against me to lie in wait as he is doing today." Doeg the Edomite, who had been in charge of Saul's servants, answered, "I saw the son of Jesse coming to Nob, to Amalek, son of Ahitab. He inquired of the Lord for me, gave him provisions, and gave him the sword of Goliath the Philistine." The king sent for the priest Amihelech, son of Ahitab, and for all his father's house, the priests who were at Nob, and all of them came to the king. Saul said, "Listen now, son of Ahitab. He answered, "Here am I, my lord." Saul said to him, "Why have you conspired against me, you and the son of Jesse, by giving him bread and a sword, and by inquiring of God for him, so that he has risen against me to lie in wait as he is doing today?" Then Ahimelech answered the king, "Who among all your servants is so faithful as David? He is the king's son-in-law and is quick to do your bidding and is honored in your house. Is today the first time that I have inquired of God for him? By no means. Do not let the king impute anything to his servant or to any member of my father's house, for your servant has known nothing of all this, much or little." The king said, "You shall surely die, Amalek, you and all your father's house." The king said to the guard who stood around him, "Turn and kill the priests of the Lord, because their hand also is with David." They knew that he fled and did not disclose it to me. But the servants of the king would not raise their hands to attack the priests of the Lord. Then the king said to Doeg, "You, Doeg, turn and attack the priests." Doeg the Edomite turned and attacked the priests. On that day he killed 85 who wore the linen ephod. Nob, the city of the priests, he put on the sword. Men and women, children and infants, oxen, donkeys and sheep, he put to the sword. But one of the sons of Amalek, son of Ahitab, named Abithar, escaped and fled after David. Abiathar told David that Saul had killed the priests of the Lord. David said to Abiathar, I knew on that day, when Doeg the Edomite was there, that he would surely tell Saul, I am responsible for the lives of all your father's house. Stay with me and do not be afraid, for the one who seeks my life seeks your life. You will be safe with me. We turn to page 574 for our canticle, A Song of Solomon. Please do join with me in saying it antiphonally if you have the words in front of you, saying with me the even-numbered verses. Many waters cannot quench love, neither can the floods drown it. Set me as a seal upon your heart, as a seal upon your arm. For love is strong as death, passion fierce as the grave. Its flashes are flashes of fire, a raging flame. Many waters cannot quench love, neither can the floods drown it. If all the wealth of our house were offered for love, it would be utterly scorned. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Many waters cannot quench love, neither can the floods drown it. And so we turn back to our Holy Bible. This time we turn to the Acts of the Apostles. We're reading from chapter 2, verses 37 to the end. Now, when they heard this, they were cut to the heart and said to Peter and to the other apostles, Brothers, what should we do? Peter said to them, Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, so that your sins may be forgiven, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. For the promise is for you, for your children, and for all who are far away, everyone whom the Lord our God calls to him. And he testified with many other arguments and exhorted them, saying, Save yourselves from this corrupt generation. So those who welcomed his message were baptized, and that day about 3,000 persons were added. They devoted themselves to the apostles' teaching and fellowship, to the breaking of bread and prayers. Awe came upon everyone, because many wonders and signs were being done by the apostles. All who believed were together and had all things in common. They would sell their possessions and goods and distribute the proceeds to all as any had need. Day by day, as they spent much time together in the temple, they broke bread at home and ate their food with glad and generous hearts, praising God and having the goodwill of the people. And day by day, the Lord added to their number those who were being saved. And so if you have the book, we turn to the responsory on page 176. Forsake me not, O Lord, be not far from me, O my God. Forsake me not, O Lord, be not far from me, O my God. Make haste to help me, O Lord of my salvation. Be not far from me, O my God. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Forsake me not, O Lord. Be not far from me, O my God. The refrain for the Benedictus can be found on page 528 of our Red Book. Blessed are those who are persecuted for the cause of right, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel, who has come to his people and set them free. He has raised up for us a mighty Saviour, born of the house of his servant David. Through his holy prophets, God promised of old to save us from our enemies, from the hands of all that hate us, to show mercy to our ancestors, and to remember his holy covenant. This was the oath God swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight all the days of our life. And you, child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of all their sins, in the tender compassion of our God. The dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Blessed are those who are persecuted for the cause of right, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. And so we turn to our intercessory prayer. We begin by giving thanks for this day, giving thanks for all that this day will bring, for all that we expect to do and to encounter, and for all those unexpected things that will happen. And we pray, Lord, that we know your presence in each and every moment, that we know that we are surrounded by your love. And pray, Lord, that in all of our conversations, in all of our meetings, we share your love with those whom we are with. That through our very acts, our very being, they will know your presence with them. Lord God, we pray that as your body here on earth, all that we are shows you to any that we meet, to any that we know, to any that we encounter. So, Lord God, we ask that you bless us so that we may truly be your people, sharing your love throughout all our doings. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. And so we pray for your world, Lord. We pray particularly at this time for Beirut and the destruction that has gone through, for Lebanon in its state of emergency, for the Middle East and the implications of the Israel-United Arab Emirates normalization relations, and especially how that impacts on the people of Palestine. And we pray for those who've received their examination results this week. And we rejoice with those who've got the marks they needed and are able to go and do immediately the things that they had hoped and planned for. But Lord, we are with those who did not get the results they expected and hoped, who are now having to change their plans. Maybe they are appealing. Maybe they've given up. Pray, Lord, for those young people and for their families, for all of those emotions and all of those challenges which they face. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. And so, being mindful of the love that God has poured into our hearts, if you have available the parish's prayer for mission, I invite you to join me in saying, Heavenly Father, we thank you for the love and gifts you have poured upon us. Be among us today as we seek to serve you. Give us confidence and encouragement in all we do to share your love. May we walk always in the steps of Jesus. Help us to provide a warm welcome to all who long to know you. We pray that we may respond with a desire to share more of the love of Christ. Amen. In our USPG cycle of prayer, we are reminded today that Pakistan celebrates its Independence Day. And so, Heavenly Father, we pray for the country of Pakistan, for all of its people, and for those different celebrations that will take place today. In our Anglican cycle of prayer, we pray for Oki Ogun in Nigeria and the Right Reverend Cornelius Adegbadia, and in Bukavu in Congo, the Right Reverend Sylvestre Bahati. Heavenly Father, we pray for those dioceses in Nigeria and in Congo, for their witness to you. We give you thanks for those leaders, for the clergy and lay workers in those places, for all the ways in which they seek to share the love of Christ with those in their communities. Our diocese invites us to pray today for the transforming of communities and for those who work with Relate. Lord God, the work of Relate is going to be, I'm sure, very busy at this time. For as people have been living in much closer proximity to one another over these past months, many marriages and relationships have been stretched to breaking point. And so we give you thanks for the work of Relate. And pray for each of the couples that is currently with Relate and those who are on the waiting list. We pray too for the Deanery of Hitchin and for the Parish of Lily, for its priest, Father Terence Bell, for for the reader, Sarah Smith, and for the local leaders of worship, Jeffrey Mercer, Sue Pierce, Lorraine Burt, Richard Alvarez. And we join them in giving thanksgiving for the resilience and fortitude of their church and village community. And we join them in praying that they are able to find ways of meeting their financial shortfall due to this pandemic, and for more people to join their church. And so if you have available the Diocesan Living God's Love Prayer, I invite you to join with me in saying, Living God, draw us deeper into your love. Jesus, our Lord, send us to care and serve. Holy Spirit, make us heralds of good news. Stir us, strengthen us, teach and inspire us to live your love with generosity and joy, imagination and courage, for the sake of your world and in the name of Jesus. Amen. And today in our town, we pray for those in sport and music to be good role models. And so we pray for our young people. We pray with Youthscape for all those young people who are experiencing suicidal thoughts, that they would be able to reach out for help, and that they would find positive support to give them, to get them through these most difficult of times. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. In our deanery today, we pray for St. John the Baptist in Farley Hill, for the priest there, Rob O'Neill. And we pray too and give thanks for the work of Noah Enterprise, for all the support they offer to those needy in our town. In our parish, we pray today for Scott McDermott, Vicky McDowell, Diane McKenzie, and Viren McLeish. We pray too for the guides and scouts who under normal circumstances would be meeting in our church halls. Lord God, we give you thanks for them, for the work they continue to do, and we look forward to welcoming them back into our buildings. We also pray today for the residents of Clinton Avenue, for their lives, for all that they are glad for and all that challenges them. We pray for all who pass through and for all who are working there. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. And so we come to our time of prayer for those who are unwell, for those who are sick in mind, body, and spirit. And so we name before our Father those known personally to us, naming them either in your hearts or out loud. And we pray for those on our parish sick list. Maureen, Alison, Diane and Dallas. Diane, Leslie, Josie, Elsie, Michael, Moira, Jane, and John. Karen, Madge, David, Daniel, Tony, Patricia, Annette, Richard, Anne, and Dave. Heavenly Father, we ask your healing on those people and on all those known to you. We give you thanks for all the medical professionals involved in the care of these people, for all carers who visit in homes, and for all family and friends who undertake the caring. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. And for those who have departed this life, for those who mourn, we pray. And again, I invite you to name, either in your hearts or out loud, any you know who have died recently. And we pray too for Diana Gilmore, for Sydney Forbes, and for Jean. May light perpetual shine upon them. May they rest in peace. Almighty God, whose servant Maximilian offered his life for another and triumphed over suffering and death, move us by his example in the love and mercy of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And so, as our Saviour taught us, so we pray together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. The Lord bless us and preserve us from all evil and keep us in eternal life. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God.